as per the requirement. Again, if you want to do it, what you can do, you create the more a meter event for that. You can click on that as per our requirement, right? Okay, so we'll go a little bit more further for that now. So that was the explosions, how we can do with the help of our trigger and the blueprint. I'll just compile. Now, what I want to do, I want to use the animations now. I want to use a character, right? I want to add, when I'll move in that particular area, my character will start it to do that animations, right? So once I'll reach, so what I'll do, first of all, I'll create a new level for you people and just say first selected this level, save selected. So I'm saving in that, again play and check, because sometimes what happen, our third person might not get there. Now what I want, this character once enter or reach into that particularly trigger area, there is a one character over here which started to do the animations. When I'll reach to this particular size and area, right, once I'll reach that particular door or cave or anything, you know, there always, when we see into the any games, once we reach into that area, we can see there are other characters who started to do the animations or started to do the act. So what we'll do first, this is our third characters over here. First of all, I am into the my new level. First of all, what I'll do, then I'll go to the my content over here. I'll just create a new folder, again new, and say folders. This is 3D underscore imported import characters. So now what I'll do, I'll import from this tab. I'll go to the my desktops. I have this untitled dinosaur character over here. If I'm importing any characters over here, I'll say import animation as well. Yes. What will be the scale size are you looking for it? I'm using for the 0.3 or 0.4. For this, I'm using a 0.2 and say import to all. So here what we'll do, my FBX, my animated character, which I've did into a Max or the Maya, right, or the Blender or any 3D software, it will come in this, and it is also depending upon, if you see you are importing anything, this is tag is coming, okay, small error is there. Here we can see all some of the, you know, the thumbnails and different color. This is a static mesh over here. I am not given the name over here, but what I'll do, I'll just drag characters over here. I'll rotate that character in front of my this scene. Now what I required, once my this game character reach over here, this character is started to do animations, or this is already animated characters, or after crossing that particular area, this character is started to do, you know, run or jump. So multiple choice and multiple options we have to do in this. First, I need to draw that character into my scene. Now what I'll do, I'll create a box trigger. If I'll go to the basic, I'll go down here, we have the box trigger. If you see the box trigger here, it is easily indicating, see, this is a trigger icon over here. I'll just do a scale as per my requirement. Once my character reach on this area, I'll select and do this one, this area, I'll just select drag and drop. Once my character reach in this area, this dinosaur has to do the animations, right? Or some kind of the movement he has to do. First, I drag that static mesh. Second, I go to my basic, or I can go over here, say box. I'll search for that. That is a box trigger over here. The trigger which I've made over here, right? When we do the trigger here, you can see some of the property, default, rotates, override settings. So multiple options we have over here. Now what we'll do, I'll select my trigger. I've just selected this, and I'll just give this name, enter, or the rename size or the rename select or F2. This is my dyna, right? And if I'll select and say browse size get here, okay, no problem. I'll again delete and just drag my dinosaur over here. So here we'll get the name of that characters and just rotate. If I'm not selecting anything, control and middle mouse, I'm changing my view. This is the like how you can change your view. Do not select anything. Control, middle mouse and drag it. You can go front view, top view, side view, perspective view. If I'll make straight, I'm going into side view. If I'm going on this, this is my front view. If I'm going up, this is my top view. If I'll do diagonally, I'm going in my perspective view. So this is the shortcut key. We can use this. Right. So I've created this dinosaurs and this is the my trigger which I've added over here. Now what I'll do, I'll select my trigger box. I'll go to my level editor because I want to do that level animations. I'll go over here. I'll just, you know, reduce the UI of this blueprint and say blueprint. Blueprint and say open level blueprint. Right. So here what I need to do first, I need to give informations to that trigger. What trigger I need to do? If my trigger is selected, if I'll go and do right click here, we are automatically options over here, add event to trigger. If I am not selected anything, if I go on my event graph or level editor here, you can see that option is not indicating. So if you want to add anything, it's better to always select your object or the trigger. For an example, I have selected this my dinosaur. I'll go right click here. We have add event for the dinosaur. Add event for the dinosaur. Here you can see create reference node. The same is used for trigger. Select your trigger, click, and here we have the reference trigger. We have add event for trigger. In add event, we have multiple options: collision, game, input, call function, trigger box. Right? So there are multiple. For this, we are using collision, add, actor, begin. Right? Once my actor or once my characters reach in this level, in this inside the trigger, is started to do actor begin overlap. Right? Now what we'll do, we have add event on actor begin overlap, right? On actor begin the overlap, that's correct. Now what we'll do, now we need to bring, compile and save. Here we are not able to see the more property. Now I need to bring my dinosaur node inside this event. Again, right click. You should be selected your 3D model. See, it is selected. Go to the event, right click and say create reference node. Here you can say this is coming into again the node which I already shown you different kind of the variables when we are doing. Now here we can say, here we have this node over here. This is my dinosaur node over here. Again, do the compile and save. Now what we have to do, I've selected my dinosaur. Now what he has to do, he has to do play animation, play space animations. Here you can say play animation skeleton mesh component. Yes. Here we can say what animation you need to play your character. Yeah, I want it has to play a tail movement. Once I've created over here, here you can see this node is automatically has created, right? So what I'll do, I'll again do the compile and I'll try to save, because where my level is save, I will save that only. Now what I'll do, I can directly drag on this to this. I'll do compile. Once my character reach inside this level, because this is my trigger event, right? This is my trigger event. Once my characters go inside, this character is started to play. And what animation is started to play? Anything which I have already reset over here. For an example, I'm using idle run, or first I'll say jump loop. I'll go down, I'll use his armatures, idle, bite, attack. It started to do attack in that, right? So again, do compile, it was not selected. You want to do the looping? Yes, you can click on that. It will, that animation will be continue. So here I can say tail or the bite. Again, compile. See, whatever changes you have to do, always click on this compile. It always has to be the, you know, the active. Click on this. Now I can go over here and say play. Here you can see my character is still. Once I'll cross in that, see the movement. Right, again stop your game, again play. Here you can see it is not moving, right? My character, dinosaur character, is not moving. Once I'll reach, if you see that particular cube trigger, it will started to do jump, it started to do the animation. See, now the thing is that if I'll select the play animations over here, we have the looping. I'll select this triggers over here. Now here you can see that will be the continue. If you want to do the looping, click on this. Again play. I'll click on this. This will be the continue. The animations will be the continue. Here I have not given that blueprint or connection that this has to be the, you know, if dinosaur is moving or kind of the action reaction is doing. But if I'll stop it again, if I'll play onto my previous. See, this is the node. Once I'll cross that. So this is will started to move, correct? Now this is the one way we can do. Now what I want, once my character, or once my this character or male character, once he's outside, once he's came from this container or the trigger, he started to do a different animations. Now here you will see this is doing the continuous, right? This is continue. If I'm going out, this is animation is continuing. It is looping. Right? Start and this play here. You can see this is once I'll reach over here. See, once I'll enter, it will started to again is looping continue. Because I have selected looping over here. If I'll turn off, again do compile and play. I'll move this and started to say that will be the till end here. You can see. Now here it is not. It is looping again because that is the end of the durations. So here you can see how I can remove once my character is gone inside. Again, if it is going inside, that character, that dinosaur animation is continuing, right? Because this is look little bit unaesthetic, which is not acceptable, right? It is jogging. So what I'll do, I'll remove this node. Here I will add do once node, correct? Do once, only once it will do select and drag and drop to the play animations. This is really very simple. Trust me, guys. This is a slowly we'll try to understand what kind of animations we required, what we can do. That is also possibility is that if I'll select start and see over here, again, it's better to if we can play over here. I'll just select and go see. See now, do once only. Now this is not starting from the very frame again. This will be the till its last frames. Now, as I already told you, once my character, it's come out from this, my dinosaur has to be the start, or it has fallen to my character. Right? Basically, normally we'll do that. But as of now, today we will see that how we can change a different animations to our characters, right? For an example, I'll select my container or the trigger box again. I'll go over here to my event graph blueprint, right click and say event, collision event, yes, what? Actor and overlap. Previously it was collision and actor begin. Now this is to be the end. Once my character's game character is coming out that trigger box, my animations, my dinosaur animations will change. So what I'll do, I'll just copy this node, control C and V, whole node I have copied, right? So again, I'll just drag this into this my object. Now here, I just need to change of my animations. Select over here, go down, which is the character preset you have, idle run. Now again, do compile. Now here you will see, once starting is static, once I reach to that container, animation is started. If I'll come out, see animation is started. See this? Right, again stop and again see looping you want to do. You can turn off and off. You can do that as well. Again do the compile and started to play or simulations. I'll click over here and say simulations over here. If I'll see my character is moving, stop, click, go over here and play. I need to stop that simulations. Start. Stop. Right? If I want to make this structure into a proper chart or proper group way, I'll just select and drag this first of all as per my requirement. Just put into as per their choice. I'll just select everything, right click and say create component from selections. So here I'm creating a group or chart which we are using into a new console. This is my trigger, trigger underscore with dinosaurs. Compile and just save. Again, play. See, I lose that one exposures to legs. Looping you want, simulations, stop, play. Right, so that way we can create this nodes with the help of the blueprint. Now, what I'll do, I'll create, if I want to use a cinematic or the different level sequence. So what I'll do, I'll again create the new level file and say the new level and normally this do not save. I am not selecting my previous level. Now what I'll do, I'll just drag these characters over here. I'll just remove this box. Right now what I'll do, if I want to use this animations clip, this is just a glimpse I'm showing you as of now. If I want to use this cinematics, right, cinematics over here, what we have under our toolbar. So what I'll do, I'll first create the new level sequence editor. It's try to save. Yes, save it. Once you save it over here, if you'll go to your content browser, see this is the new level. Here what we are seeing, this is the new level which we have created, right? So I'll select my dinosaur characters from the outliner. Now drag and drop to my timeliner. If I'll click on this cinematics over here, level sequences, I'm getting these options. Once I've created this, this node will add into my content browsers. So try to save current over here and just save. Right, this node is saved. Now if I click on this animation, it will ask on which character what. If animation here is the some presets which we have, it is automatically selected which animations can apply. So second is the idle bite over here or attack of the tail. If I'll start in the place, just start in this place, select and play. So this is the tail animations. So this is my start and the end frames. Now if I want to blend, if you'll see my time duration, I need to increase. Correct? If I'm going into my animation here, we have the transform. If I want to animate or if I want to give animations to this transform, I need to click on this keyframe here. We can see the keys led, but not to this layer animations. Normally what we are doing into the Maya, we have the tracks editor where we can import or we can blend two different animated clips together. The same rule apply over here. I have imported my characters into my scene. Then I dragged from my outliners to my sequence editors. If I want to import more clips, I'll click on this plus animations. This time I will say byte. Here you can see the two animation is added over here. Now we'll just see the durations of that. This is my tail. Now select drag and drop. Now this I want to be a little bit, you know, forward and back. Now here I will increase the durations of my timeline. Just control and middle mouse timeline for zoom in, zoom out and the maximize. If you start and play here, you can see this is doing amateurs. Then after you can see it started to jump. Right? Now what I'll do, if I'll stop this, if I'll move my, I'll move this my clip here, you can see it is already started to do the blending with my previous animations. Here you can see this is already started. I'll just drag this up. I'll pull this my character a little bit up so that way easily we can see this. I'll just drag it over here. I'll just select and move my key here, you can see. So here I'm started to get that blending from one animation to second animation. See this? This is attacking, right? So this is my tail animations we have. Then we have the different animations clip. As of now, we are not using this into our blueprint, but very soon I will show in my next sessions how we can use all this blue animated clip into a blue script, because we need to first understand what is a blueprint, blueprint class, blueprint level. If I'm to add anything, now first we'll try to move a run animation. So this is the run animation I'll put into the same clip. This is the on the attack, then this will try to blend on the same clip over here. Now select and play. Spacebar is the shortcut key to play that. So it started to get right, but it is moving. The dinosaur is moving into the one character. Now if you see the my time duration, I need to move this red line here. Now what I'll do, I'll just start it to click over here and I'll just go to the transform and locations. I'm looking for to go into the y directions. I'll give that key on that particularly transform. So I'll go to my last frame. I'll move that over here from this to this. You want, please make sure if you're, you know, scrolling, it will give the little bit higher value. So I'll see this is the my animations clip. And if I'll start to play this, start and play this, see, this is the very simple way we can do. So again, we can do this modification as per the requirement. If you want to increase, go to this last keyframes. If you want to give the more, you can do that as well. It is in your hand. So here we can see this is the started to move. You want to reduce it, stop, control Z. Go to the next frame and just select and put it over here. This is depending upon you. So in my next, you know, the blueprint session, I will try to show how you can use this once my character reach on that trigger, correct? How this character can follow. So there are multiple, and as for the, you know, the like lecture wise, I'm showing you this detail, how you can take the lecture, how you can, you know, teach this blueprint informations level.